Hello and welcome to the last video of inorganic gastrointestinal agents. In this video, we will have discussion on saline catheterics. After completion of this video, students will be able to classify the catheterics and students will be able to explain the mechanism of action of catheterics. So think on these two questions. Pause the video, try to get answer of these questions and then play the video. Questions are: definition of constipations and which agents are used to relieve the constipation. So constipation is nothing but the insufficient intestine motility or peristalsis. In constipation, there is infrequent bowel movement and small and hard to pass the stool. That condition is known as constipation. The catheterics, the drugs, are used for the treatment of constipation. The catheterics are used to relieve the constipation because that drugs has ability to accelerate the defecation. Catheterics, laxative and purgatives. These three terms are used for the drugs which has ability for the treatment of constipation. Laxatives are mild catheterics while purgatives are strong catheterics. There are four types of catheterics. This classification is mainly based on the action of catheteric drugs. Means this classification is based on mechanism of action of catheterics. First class is stimulant or irritant type purgatives, for example phenolphthalein or senna. Next is bulk producing drugs, for example isabgol or methyl cellulose. Next class is emollient or lubricant, or it is also called as stool softeners, for example liquid paraffin, that is mineral oil. And last is saline catheterics, or it is also called as osmotic laxative, for example magnesium sulfate. So let's discuss one by one. First is stimulant or irritant type purgatives. These are the chemical agents which are act by local irritation on intestinal tract and brings stimulation of peristalsis activity. As it has ability to irritate the intestinal tract, because of irritation of intestinal tract, there is stimulation of secretion of excess fluids and electrolytes within the intestine, and this will leads to the stimulation of peristalsis activity. They act by directly on intestine and stimulate the peristalsis, so they are called as stimulants. For example, phenolphthalein and senna. Second class is bulk producing drugs. Bulk, so it will increase the volume. It will increase the bulk of intestinal contents. These drugs are cellulose or non-digestive material which swell when it wet and due to which increased bulk of intestinal content, and due to that there is leads to stimulate the peristalsis. So these drugs are insoluble, non-digestive material, and it will get swell when it is in contact with water, and due to swelling of such a material there is bulk of intestinal content take place, and because of that there is stimulation of peristalsis movement. So it will promote the evacuation by increasing the stool's bulk volume and water content. That's why these drugs are called as bulk producing drugs, for example isabgol and methyl cellulose. Next class is emollient lubricant. It is also called as stool softener, as These drugs has ability to penetrate, lubricate and soften the stools. Lubricants brings smooth clearance and lubricating of fecal material. For example, mineral oil, that is liquid paraffin. And last type of catheretics are saline catheretics. It is also called as osmotic purgative or osmotic catheretics. Saline catheretics are principally a salt of poorly absorbable ions, which thereby increase the osmotic load on intestinal tract. And because of that, the hypertonicity gets produced. So within the intestine, content of electrolyte get increased because of this saline catheretics, that is hypertonicity within the intestine. So this hypertonicity is relieved by the secretion of additional fluids and electrolytes into the intestinal tract in order to maintain the hypertonicity. So due to additional fluids and the electrolytes in intestinal tract, it will stimulate the peristalsis of the intestine. So it will increase the bulk in intestine and stimulate the peristalsis and bowel movement. So excessive loss of body fluids. Therefore, these agents should be taken with large amount of water as it reduces the nausea and vomiting. As name indicates, it is osmotic laxative. So first it will produce hypertonicity, so imbalance of electrolytes. In order to maintain the electrolyte balance, the body secretes the excessive fluids and electrolytes into intestine. So because of that, there is chance of excessive loss of body fluids. So in order to overcome this problem, this agent should be taken with the large amount of water. For example, sodium potassium tartrate and magnesium sulfate. So I request to the students to make a chart of inorganic compounds given in gastrointestinal agents. So that charts containing serial number, name of compound, synonym and molecular formula, properties and uses. This table will helpful to the students for the study of inorganic compounds under gastrointestinal agents. So far we have discussed about the catheretics, its classification based on mechanism of action. Thank you for watching this video. Wish you all the best.